I'm Dave from Thomas Jacks, and this is the Merger Mega Test, Part 4, to find the identification range of the different Merger thermal binoculars in our industry standard ID test for thermals. For this ID Merger Mega Test, each of the Merger thermal binoculars are side by side, so you can judge the identification capabilities for yourself of the Merger LRF XQ35s, Merger LRF XP50s, and Merger LRF XL50s. So for today's test, we're looking to see how far we can safely identify dogs and their dog walkers. We'll be using the laser rangefinder on the mergers to just check the distance, and we'll also have a picture-in-picture window open so you can see whether or not Zoom is helping with that identification process. Now the weather, it's dry, it's bright, humidity's at about 77% and it is freezing cold. Now, if you find these mega tests helpful, don't forget to subscribe because there's quite a few of them to help you decide which merger is right for you. Now, on with the test. I'll benchmark each on this scale of level of confidence for identifying dogs as definitely dogs from shape and behaviour. And to confidently ID a person, we need good clothing detail to spot their gender or the nature of what they're up to. Here's our first subject. On all three mergers, we can clearly work out it's a workman, so at this range, I'm 100% confident about identification. And that's at 174 meters. Let's scan around to find someone else. Up by the tree line, we can detect a walker with a large and a small dog. Too far away for a safe ID, but we'll come back to that range later and focus on the nearer walker to begin with. He's at 242 meters, with good detail on his build and his jacket, definitely male on the XLs and XPs, to both score 100%. And the Merger XQ35s give enough detail to make me 80% confident on an ID. How about the man halfway up the hill? Under normal circumstances, I'd be zooming in more with the big XP and XL sensors to help me ID. But for ease and consistency in this test, I'll just keep everything at 5x mag. So he's at 513 meters. And just for reference, that far tree line, that's at 660 meters. Back to the walker at 513 meters. The XP's larger 17 micron pixels pick him out really well, with some nice edge detail to his form and some tonal variation for 60% ID confidence. For an experienced user, applying more zoom, that's probably good enough. More pixels in the XL delivers more refined temperature readings for slightly better shading and shape, so 70% confident. The XQs are certainly on the scale spotting a person walking briskly, but that's at 30% for me. So scanning the area, we've got dogs and dog walkers at 217 meters. A really nice clear 100% ID on two men and a lady with the XP and XL. Viewing a picture-in-picture overlay on the wider view is the best of both worlds for identifying on these mergers. And as you may have seen in our long-range detection Mega Test 2, with these you can easily zoom into 10x, even 20x on the XP and XLs to make it easier to ID what you see, if you only have to control one unit. The XQs give a nice level of detail, and I'm 80 to 85% confident of an XQ identification at this range. The HD displays in both eyes is more immersive than a monocular, so it's comfortable, especially in daylight, which is definitely helpful for a task like this out in the field. Looking for something else. The LRF on the XP50 suggests this dog walker is on the same path as the other dog walkers. So let's search for something a bit further. Let's check that. Yeah, 467 meters. Someone's stray dog up there by the trees. Now, they're certainly carrying something, a kite or a model aeroplane. At 436 meters, which we'll come back to. At over 700 meters, the XQs spot a person with some dog-sized shapes, but I'd only be 20% confident on anything useful to ID them. The XPs and XLs offer a little more of what's possibly a hunched-over male from the shape and movement, at 40% confidence, and that might have been higher if I'd zoomed in more to take advantage of the extra pixels. As for the person carrying something, sticking with the XLs, I'd confidently say that's a man carrying a model aeroplane, 100%, and on the XPs too, 100%. There's a pretty good amount of detail on the XQs, so 50% confidence on an ID with the XQs now at 366 meters. Now let's fast forward a bit. This is interesting. I'd be 100% confident with a safe ID on the dogs, a woman and a man on the XPs at 437 meters. No problem on the XLs here, but let's wait for them to get to the hedge and reassess at 470 meters. On the XQs, I think they're beyond a reasonably safe ID, so here 45 to 50%. Cutting forward, let's see what we think. I think the XLs give a safe 100% ID at 470 meters. The XPs I would put at 70%. The XQs at 40% at 470 meters. And so to conclude, if you want to safely ID at a range of 200 meters, get the Merger XQ35s. But for the capability to ID over 400 meters, you need the Merger XP50. Or get the Merger XL if you want to be able to ID up to around 500 meters. To see more of our mega tests comparing Pulsar thermals in different controlled field tests, subscribe or click this link. And for details of any of these mergers, visit tj-focus.co.uk. I'm Dave at Thomas Jacks. Thanks for watching.